morning, St. Paul's. I'm so glad to see you. I'm so glad to see so many of you. Welcome to everybody who's joining us in person. Welcome to everyone who joins us on K-Way FM radio. And welcome to everyone who's joining us on live stream. I especially want to say greetings from one of our live stream worshipers, Mr. Fred Stummy, worships with us every week from the great state of Maryland. He has association with us from the old days back with the school, and he wanted me to tell you hello. If you're also a live streamer or radio listener and want to bring greetings, just give me a call or shoot me an email. I'd be happy to do that. This is going to be one of those days where the announcements are longer than the sermon. I know you don't like that, but I can't help it because there's so much ministry going on here. All right, let's begin. Fill out the welcome pad so we know you're here. All of the announcements, you can find the details in, you know, all the places, the emails, the online, the printed thing in the back. But let me just bring up some things that are most important. We still have job openings for this fall. We need some teaching associates. We got full-time jobs. We got part-time jobs. We've got part of part-time jobs. Maybe you're not looking, but I bet you know somebody who could be a great associate. We're looking for people that love Jesus and love children and don't want a lot of money. Those are three qualifications. So look around your neighborhood, look around your relatives. Give us a call with some really good people. Let's talk about church dinners. Monday night, starting at 5 o'clock, Saints Cafe. Tuesday, senior adult lunch, starting at 10:30. Wednesday, there'll be a family campfire worship out in the green space. Come, and I'll have some songs and a nice campfire. It's for families. What does family mean? Anything you want it to mean. If you want to come have campfire worship, come on over. Deb Bachman will be leading that. Next Sunday, July 2nd, only at the 11 o'clock service, we'll be having outdoor church, weather permitting, and it'll be over in the green space, over in the playground, and we'll be celebrating the blessing of the beasts. So bring your pets, and we'll bless each and every pet you bring. Pets are very much welcome. Not at 9, no, but at 11. And after worship, there'll be root beer floats and little treats for the critters. Now, if your pet is the kind of pet that probably wouldn't enjoy that, like a house cat or a Tyrannosaurus Rex or, you know, that's okay. You can bring a picture of your pet or a collar or a favorite toy, anything that you associate with your pet. That's great. Okay. You know that I would never plug one store. That would be wrong. But I do want to point this out. One of our grocery stores is having a huge sale on diapers. If you get the right brand, if you spend $50, you get 75 cents a gallon off. And next month, we're going to be looking for our micro mission. We'll be collecting diapers for the food shelf. Just saying, the deal's only good to July 2nd. So just a little hint there. And Vacation Bible School. There's a board in the old narthex, and you can just pick a little thing off that board. It'll be an item that we need, like pretzels or cheese sticks or something. And you just take that, then take that with you, go to the store, bring back supplies for Vacation Bible School. That's how we make Vacation Bible School free for every kid. And how many kids are coming as of today? 140 children will be at Vacation Bible School. Yep. That's the good work of Deb Bachman and her team, and they could really use a few more volunteers, because if you have 140 children, you need 139 volunteers. So we're looking for volunteers for that. Okay, I want to acknowledge and welcome my dear friend and trusted colleague, Pastor Steve Brackett, is joining us for worship today. Pastor Brackett serves as assistant to the bishop, and he has come to observe our congregational special meeting. As you know, your church council has called a special meeting for 10 o'clock today. As you know, there's going to be two items. First, the church council has already made a motion, and second, to issue a call to a new lead pastor, a normal pastor, and should that pass, we'll be voting on the compensation package. I know that you've got some real serious concerns. I'm going to tell you we've got you covered. There will be coffee and cookies in the parish hall, fair trade in the parish hall, and script in the parish hall. We got everything taken care of. We're looking forward to a great meeting. And as you know, we need to have 100 people present or the meeting's a failure. So it is mandatory that everybody, immediately after this worship service, skedaddle to the parish hall. Are you with me? You know we got one more piece of business we got to do. We got to look up to the camera, giving thanks that it rained, and say, good morning, friends. Thank you so much. Would you please rise? Let's begin worship. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God of all mercy and consolation, come to the help of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of your Holy Spirit, that we may confess our sin, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of Jesus Christ, have mercy on us, forgive us, renew us, and lead us so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways. To the glory of your holy name. Amen. God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead in sin and made us alive together with Christ. By grace, you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith. Amen. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
the Church of God and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the
be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Teach us, good Lord God, to serve you as you deserve, to give and not to count the cost, to fight and not to heed the wounds, to toil and not to seek for rest, to labor and not to ask for reward, except that of knowing that we do your will. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Please remain standing for the gospel.
Reading from Matthew, the 10th chapter. Jesus said to the 12, "A disciple is not above the teacher, nor a slave above the master. It is enough for the disciple to be called the teacher, and the slave to be like the master. If they have called the master of the house Beelzebul, how much more will they malign those of his household? So have no fear of them, for nothing is covered up that will not be uncovered, and nothing secret that will not become known. What I say to you in the dark, tell in the light. And what you hear whispered, proclaim from the housetops. Do not fear those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather fear him who can destroy both soul and body in hell. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny? Yet not one of them will fall to the ground apart from your Father. And even the hairs of your head are all counted. So do not be afraid. You are of more value than many sparrows. Everyone, therefore, who acknowledges me before others, I also will acknowledge before my Father in heaven. But whoever denies me before others, I will also deny before my Father in heaven. Do not think that I have come to bring peace in the earth. I have not come to bring peace, but a sword. For I have come to set a man against his father, a daughter against her mother, a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. And one's foes will be the members of one's own household. Whoever loves father and mother more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up the cross and follow me is not worthy of me. Those who find their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake will find it. The Gospel of our Lord.
Children, come on up. Let's have a children's sermon. Good morning. Good morning, Evie. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, Charles. Good morning. What's this? Toothpaste? Okay, good. I need a volunteer. Hands up, volunteer. Thank you, Evie. Come on up. Come on, Evie. Okay. Hold out your paw. Up, other way. Yep, very good. We'll just put a little toothpaste right on there. How's that? Good? Okay, now hold this in your other hand. Put the toothpaste back in. How's it going? Not good? Evie, what are you doing wrong? Oh, Evie, you're making a mess. Oh, Evie, you can't put toothpaste back into a tube, can you? No. In the same way, sometimes when we say things, we can't take them back. And so that's why we need to be really careful about what we say and always say things that are pleasing and helpful, especially when we're talking about Jesus. Jesus loves to hear us use his name in praise, but not as a naughty word in cussing. In fact, generally, I'm going to say you should never use any naughty words. So we're going to be talking about that with the adults today because, you know, sometimes parents use naughty words. We're going to teach them not to do that. And then I'm going to help you with your paw here. It's just some bleach. You won't mind. Alex, okay if I put bleach on your kid?
Sure.
Yeah. Oh, he said, yeah, go for it. Yeah. You know what? I'm going to send back another one of these cloths. Your mom can help you a little bit. Okay. Don't use naughty language. That's your lesson for today. Please go back and sit with the people who brought you.
I've been wanting to do that all week. Grace be unto you and peace from God, who is our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. So we're starting off our summer preaching on the Ten Commandments. You remember 2 weeks ago we started talking about how the commandments are not a bad thing, but they're a blessing. They're a fence around our lives to keep us from evil. And then last week we talked about the first commandment, you shall have no other gods. And we remembered that not all false idols are golden calves. Sometimes they're distractions like money or sports or kids' sports. Today we're going to turn to the second commandment. You shall not take the name of God in vain. I've chosen for the preaching text Exodus chapter 3, beginning at verse 13. But Moses said to God, if I come to the Israelites and say to them, the God of your ancestors has sent me to you, and they ask me, what is his name? What shall I say to them? And God said to Moses, I am who I am. He said further, thus you shall say to the Israelites, I am has sent me to you. God also said to Moses, thus you shall say to the Israelites, the Lord, the God of your ancestors, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob has sent me to you. This is my name forever and my title for all generations. Here ends the reading. Because, as you saw with the children, the meaning of the second commandment, you shall not take the name of your God in vain, is so simple and clear, this will be a very short sermon. Stop your cussing. Amen. Just kidding, you know me better than that. The commandment, in fact, has very little or nothing to do with cussing, and it won't actually be a short sermon. Well, let's get this part over with. I think we can all agree that cussing is a bad habit and generally unattractive. There are, however, some situations that seem to require a good cuss. However, cursing with the Lord's name really is a breach of the second commandment and to be vigorously avoided. The simple teaching here is don't cuss, but if you must, don't use the Lord's name. That being said, this commandment is about so much more than just cuss words. What did Martin Luther teach about the second commandment? You remember now? Martin Luther was condemned as a heretic. He is going home. He is kidnapped by agents of Friedrich the Wise, and they take him to a castle. What's the name of the castle? Which is in a town. What's the name of the town? Excellent. When he was there in the castle, he wrote two very important books. They're both catechisms. One was small, in order for parents to teach their children. What's the name of that book? Where can you find a copy of that book? He also wrote a much larger book for pastors. What's the name of that catechism that was larger? And in that large catechism, Martin Luther wrote, it is a misuse of God's name if we call upon the Lord God in any way whatsoever to support falsehood or wrong of any kind. Luther gave examples. If you go to testify in court and you promise to tell the whole truth and nothing but the truth, so help you God, and then you lie or mislead the court, you're using the Lord's name in vain. Again, Luther talked about examples involving money. If you swear by saying, so help me God, this is the best deal I can offer, you're taking the Lord's name in vain. Luther adds, to lie or deceive is in itself a gross sin, but it's greatly aggravated when you attempt to justify or confirm it by invoking God's name, for a single lie now becomes a double lie, lies upon lies, sins upon sins. So the second commandment, you shall not take the name of God in vain, means you do not use God's name to lie. Do not use it to swear an oath. What does Jesus teach us about that? Well, okay, Matthew chapter 5, Jesus said, again, you've heard that it is said of those of ancient times, you shall not swear falsely, but carry out the vows you've made to the Lord. But I say to you, do not swear at all, either by heaven, for it's the throne of God, or by earth, for it's the footstool, or by Jerusalem, for it's the city of the great king. And do not swear on your head, you cannot make one hair white or black. Let your word be yes, yes, or no, no. Anything else comes from the evil one. What else? One more important thing. Luther called out clergy. He said the greatest abuse is when false preachers arise and peddle their lying nonsense as the word of God. He said the greatest abuse is when false preachers arise and peddle their lying nonsense as the word of God. Does that ever really happen? It does, mostly on TV. The classic example of taking the Lord's name in vain comes just days after the 9/11 attack. I'll quote to you from The Guardian. You already know that's a London-based newspaper, September 17th, 2001. Quote, "The Reverend Jerry Falwell and Pat Robinson set off a minor explosion of their own when they asserted on U.S. television that an angry God had allowed the terrorists to succeed in their deadly mission because the United States had become a nation of abortion, homosexuality, secular schools and courts, and the American Civil Liberties Union." When a pastor goes on TV and says that God allowed the terrorists to kill all those innocent people because of the American Civil Liberties Union, because our schools and courts are too secular, they are lying about God. And that is a serious breach of the second commandment. You shall not take the Lord's name in vain. Westboro Baptist Church, remember them? They would show up in small towns and picket the burial of American heroes, veterans of the Afghan War. They would picket them with signs that said that God wanted these soldiers to die because we are too inclusive in our country. That's telling a lie about God. And telling a lie about God is breaking the second commandment. When someone loses a child and you say, well, God took your child because they needed another voice in the heavenly choir, you've taken the Lord's name in vain. God does not kill children to get more sopranos. What then shall we do? Perhaps to be safe, we should just never use the Lord's name. That way we could never do it wrong. No, God wants us to call upon him. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny? Yes, not one of them will fall to the ground apart from the Father. And even the hairs on your head are all counted. So do not be afraid to call upon the Lord. You are of more value than many sparrows. So we should use the Lord's name, and often, but use it correctly. How do we do that? We should call upon the Lord and cling to him when we're in trouble. Are you in grief at the loss of a loved one? Call upon the Lord. God loves you and can reassure you that you will be reunited. Are you afraid or anxious? Who's not? Call upon the Lord. God loves you and wants to quell your fears. Are you filled with joy and you just want to shout God's praises? Call upon the Lord. God loves to hear you and wants to hear you worship. Does the Bible talk about this? Psalm 50, call upon me in the day of trouble, and I will deliver you, and you will glorify me. Remember, each and every time we gather for worship, we always say one particular prayer. It's a prayer that the Lord taught us. What's the name of that prayer? And in the Lord's Prayer, what do we say that we want God's name to be? Hallowed. That means holy. We're praying, God, may your name be holy. And we can help make God's name holy by not abusing it. Abusing it by using it incorrectly or abusing it by neglect. God loves you. God is desirous to hear from you, to hear your prayers, to hear your praise. It is God's good pleasure that you should call upon him. He is waiting to hear from you. Your homework for this week is to pray. Pray for this congregation. Pray for your family. Pray for our country. And know that God loves you. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you for joining St. Paul's Lutheran Church and School by live stream or on K-Way 99.3 FM broadcasting from Waverly, Iowa. Today is the fourth Sunday that follows Pentecost. The radio broadcast is sponsored by Willis and Jane Huck in honor of their 70th anniversary. Wow. The altar flowers are given by Paul and Christy Lyons in celebration of their anniversary. Happy anniversary, both you good couples. Now, if you want to participate in this morning's offering, you can give online at stpaulswaverly.org. If you want to participate in any of our activities, like the senior lunch or enroll your children in Vacation Bible School, go to our website, stpaulswaverly.org/register. Have a great week. Blessings on you and your family, and be kind. Let us confess the faith of the Church, the faith in which we baptize. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Trusting in God's abundant mercy, let us offer our prayers for a world in need. You entice your church to speak truth that challenges false notions of your love. Prevail upon us with the good news of Christ's death and resurrection, that we are compelled to share the gospel with all the world. God, in your mercy. Under your watch, not even a sparrow goes unnoticed. Safeguard animal habitats. Bless the plants in the field and grant us rain for an abundant harvest. Amplify the voices of those calling for responsible stewardship of the earth's resources. God, in your mercy. Our world is enduring violence and destruction. Rescue your people and nations experiencing conflict or crisis, including Uganda, Ukraine, and Sudan. Thwart the efforts of those who sow chaos and terror, and guide those working to bring about peace and reconciliation. God, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
You have counted even the hairs of our heads. Reassure anyone experiencing poverty, homelessness, unemployment, or exploitation that every life has value. Bring healing upon all who struggle from illness or injury, especially Drew Anderegg, Geraldine Bushing, June Hicks, and Amy Snow Lindell. Grant comfort for Karen Dickman at the loss of her sister. Answer us, for your steadfast love is good. God, in your mercy. Even when we experience rejection, your love invites us to new life. Lift up anyone who feels shunned or excluded on account of their gender, race, sexual orientation, gender identity, national origin, or any other human distinction. Make your people one. God, in your mercy. All who have died with Christ also live with him. We give thanks for all the saints whose faithful confession inspired our own discipleship and raise us with them to eternal life. God, in your mercy. Receive our prayers and answer us, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always. Please greet one another with words of peace. Let us pray. Holy God, gracious and merciful, you bring forth food from the earth and nourish your whole creation. Turn our hearts towards those who hunger in any way, that all may know your care, and prepare us now to feast on the bread of life, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, almighty, and merciful God, you are most holy, and great is the majesty of your glory. You so loved the world that you gave your only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have eternal life. We give you thanks for his coming into the world to fulfill for us your holy will, and to accomplish all things for our salvation. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." For as oft as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Remembering, therefore, his salutary command, his life-giving passion and death, his glorious resurrection and ascension, and the promise of his coming again, we give thanks to you, O God Almighty, not as we ought, but as we are able. We ask you mercifully to accept our praise and thanksgiving with your word and Holy Spirit to bless us, your servants, and these your own gifts of bread and wine, so that we and all who share in the body and blood of Christ may be filled with heavenly blessing and grace and receive the forgiveness of sin, may be formed to lives as your holy people and be given our inheritance with all your saints. To you, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be all honor and glory in your holy church, now and forever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated.
Mercy on us.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us through the healing power of this gift of life. In your mercy, strengthen us through this gift in faith toward you and in fervent love toward one another, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine on you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and grant you peace. Amen.
Serve the Lord.